because I found my old save game from 2015, so I have my souped up car.
Digging around. Right.
I told John yesterday, I was like, I drove for like 30 souped seconds car. And then catapulted it into a pool in somebody's backyard. And I was like, fuck! So I had to just leave the car there.
It's like upside down in a pool.
It'll respawn in my garage. But it's there. Bulletproof and all.
Yeah.
Turbo.
Well, if you don't have it in... I think you need to have it in the special garage thing.
Yes, man.
Okay.
It'll
I've destroyed it many a times.
Okay.
I was surprised. In your garage, right?
Yeah.
Either that or, like, I remember you had to go to, like, an impound to get certain cars out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That's if you the police get you.
I've had it just where I've abandoned cars. Maybe it's a PS3 thing, but like I'd abandoned a car that I had souped up and I put in my garage.
Yeah, we're on PS 11D.
Shut up.
PlayStations.
Yeah.
Shut up.
Where if we're rolling, just cut out this part where I'm like, if we're rolling, and we can just continue with this.
I know y'all be loving this shit right here. LIMP. This kid is it right here. People in the
Josh,
house.
Josh, are you okay?
Put your hands in the air.
Oh, okay.
Why?
You were struggling with your body.
Because if you don't care, then we don't care.
All right.
Limp Bizkit.
Well, I'm glad you guys could join me. We watched some great movies. What's up, guys? I'm James, and this is Cinema Shat.
Yep.
And I'm where we talk about movies and TV and entertainment and what else, guys?
Yeah, it's pretty
Your
cool.
Your recent parole visit. Our lives.
Right. Absolutely.
Josh's grandma's meal plan.
Yeah, she's... We'll have to do updates on that, by the way. Stuff is getting crazy. We'll come back to it.
Okay. Yeah, I'm joined in the studio, as always, with my boys, Josh and Jan.
Yes.
And today we're going to talk about two movies that, Josh, you picked. Great movies, by the way.
Don't patronize me.
I'm not patronizing you. It was a great time to pick those because I really
wanted... You're doing a great job, buddy. High five.
Yeah.
I really wanted to watch the first and second of movies we've already watched.
Fucking bitch left me hanging.
So, Josh, with an A, he picked... You picked... What was the first one?
Black Cobra 2.
Oh, yeah.
Which I think was a strong choice.
There were such good picks that James couldn't remember them.
Oh no! I've been thinking about them so I wouldn't forget because there was so much ridiculousness in both films. But yeah, we watched Black Cobra 2 because we had already seen the first one, and then we watched Python 1.
Oh yeah, Python. Okay.
Because we had already watched Python 2.
Oh yeah, it was a sequel night.
It was a sequel prequel night.
Sequel prequel.
So Josh, do you want to catapult us into the plot of Black Cobra?
Sure, yeah.
I've been thinking intently about it so I wouldn't forget it for this moment.
But yeah, we watched... Black Cobra was fucking great. We had a good time watching the first one. Basic plot is he's... we already talked about it on a previous episode, but he is a cop that does whatever he wants.
Yeah.
He, you know, he's above the law, and he...
I am the law!
He basically... He operates on the... it's better to ask for forgiveness and permission, way of doing police work.
Also, Fred Williamson's way of life.
Really?
Oh, yeah. He's killed many people.
Oh, really? He's done many an OJ.
He's done horrible, horrible things.
Really? I thought he was just a footballer.
Things that I wouldn't even dare repeat on this very podcast, which I'm going to list.
Okay.
List them all,
I'm assuming Fred Williamson is like...
He was
greatest.
In Black Cobra 2.
Right.
That's enough of a travesty as in its own right.
But yeah, it's basically an Italian like action film.
Like the first
both
one
of them
is.
Were,
yeah.
Yeah. And yeah, it's kind of like it reminded me of in
Once Upon a Time in Hollywood.
Yeah, exactly. Where he's like, well, my career is kind of nosediving, but the Italians really want me.
That's very true.
I have power in Italy, so he goes over and. Anyway, the plot is...
What's the next 5 seconds of the movie, Josh?
So he is he's a cat, and he does whatever he wants.
In Chicago.
And,
in Chicago.
So they're trying to catch this dude, and that's the basic plot, right? I can barely remember.
It's okay.
In Josh's defense,
Big City Cup. Fred Williamson. He's on paid leave.
He goes on vacation
to Manilla Folder.
Oh my god.
He goes to the beautiful country of Manilla Folder, where hijinks ensue. There's the movie.
Yeah, basically, yeah. They wanted to go on vacation. Yeah. And they got some pretty good tax breaks in Manila.
Yep. He's literally kicking ass so much in Chicago, they're like, hey, you gotta go to Manila. I mean, remember that cop?
Yeah, you get the
chief or
you get
whatever?
You get the tax breaks, and then it's also like, I have 12 American dollars. I can live like a king here!
For real. How many folders can I buy?
I bet you only anything, staples. They had stock footage of establishing shots of Chicago.
Yeah. Probably.
And they shot everything in Manila.
Yeah.
And they bought some stock footage for Chicago.
Well, there's one scene in Chicago where they're in Chicago, but that's in like a room, so it very well could have been just...
Right.
Yeah. It's exterior. I don't know, isn't there a car chase? There's a car chase in the beginning of the streets of Chicago.
Well, it could be. It could also be Manila. That's what I was thinking.
Oh, okay. I see what you're saying.
They shot everything there. Maybe.
I don't know. It looked sad and depressing, so it could have been Chicago.
It could have been, yeah. That's
well,
true.
That would be present
But it looked
Chicago.
Sad and depressing, so it could have also been Manila.
Yeah. So, yeah, he goes there, and he gets wrapped up in a whole, like, gang murder mystery thing. Somebody's boyfriend gets murdered, and so he goes to investigate that guy with the beautiful love interest who... can sing? Question mark?
Oh, yeah. Now I remember.
She's got the look.
What the fuck are you saying? Are you even saying words?
Yeah, remember?
Genuinely.
It's a lounge scene where the chick is singing. That's what the scene is. We've seen it a trillion times. And... She what James is doing for the listeners, he's slow turning like the chick did in the movie, and she had this really dumb look on her face, so we're all laughing
like deer in a headlights,
like, yeah, like
seconds before getting struck by the truck,
like she was hired 5 minutes before the scene started, like she
hey does this fit, dress
right
fit
off,
you
right off the Great. Street
yeah. Holy what, shit you're hot
yeah what's your acting experience. Acting? You're hired.
Acting?
But you guys remember they're doing all the shots that you do when she's singing. Like they're panning down to her buttocks.
Oh my god, they're going up and down her silhouette.
Yes. And the best one is when they they pan down from her face down to her feet.
Oh yeah.
But there's a table in the way. Yeah. And it's all blurry and they hold on the table and we're like, what the fuck is going on? This is in the movie. They're holding on this blurry table. That was funny.
That was great.
Let me turn off the projector while we chat.
Projector.
Yeah, that was one of the scenes, and that was one of the funniest scenes because she looked just like an empty shell of a human being told to sing. And of course, this is an Italian film, and so they're recording the actor and actress's normal voices. We've established this before in previous podcasts, but just as a recap. So they speak or sing, in this case, in their normal voice, and then it's usually dubbed. However, her singing was not dubbed. I think she was literally just on the stage with the set microphone just singing into it. And it was just like, this is horrible.
Yeah.
And hilarious.
It's a bad song. But yeah, I always thought that was funny. Is even on set, if they speak English, they still redo all the audio later. Yeah.
Well, you can't have an accent because it's real Hollywood movie.
Well, even if they're American.
And that's what I'm saying. Like, they dub the voice. Like, imagine how
many... the actor that was acting will dub his own voice.
Would he be Fred Williamson?
Yeah.
I don't know. I think his was normal the whole time. It had to have been.
Well, it could have been, but they don't have, like, mics on set.
Right. Oh, that's a good point.
Like, so...
Well, this was Black Cobra 2. Okay, the first one was a pretty smashing success, I want to say.
Yeah, it was pretty great.
Yeah.
It
was
a good fucking movie.
I would say it was better than the second one. I think that's fair
to say. Absolutely,
yeah. So they probably had a bigger budget, so they may have been able to get one boom mic.
It's possible, yeah. It's possible. That's what they did. Yeah.
They're like, yeah, our next movie's going to be even better. We're going to have... two booms.
Maybe even more than one shot to cut from.
Hey, can we get another key light? Because they just had the one. there's just like flooding, like whatever scene they're in, they're like, key light, floodlight.
That's when they actually lit the movie.
Yeah. Like the airport.
There was one scene where they light the movie.
Yeah. Yeah. The airport, he's like walking into the actual, I remember like at one point the camera's, you know, tracking Fred Williamson, Cobra Nero. And the camera is panning as it's tracking him, and you could see the floodlight like all the way back in the room, like it was just spiking the lens, but it just looked like a lens flare. But I was like, ah, that's the light lighting this entire scene. There's one light for this entire scene.
It was pointed at that actual camera.
It was pointed at the his final mark where he was going to end up.
Gotcha.
So it was flooding all of the people walking, you know, going to their gates and stuff in the terminal. And then it stops at this, where Fred Williamson stops. That's where it's properly lit, I guess, per se.
Oh, okay. Nice. I didn't even notice that.
I just noticed people walking in and out of, like, just light. Like, they would be dark and then light all of a sudden. It was just really funny.
But, yeah, so the opening scene, you know how most action films have an opening scene to get your blood pumping, get you excited?
I'm pretty action-y pumped. Moment.
Yeah. This one has 10 establishing shots that are uncut. They use the entire shot, and it's panning from building to building. And, you know, about 5 minutes in, I think we know where we are, right? Mm-hmm. Chicago.
Chicago.
We know what's going on, but they still keep showing shots. And then they have the blind man that walks for 30 minutes. Just walking.
Oh yeah, we thought that was gonna be
this
Black
was
Cobra.
The...
going to pull off like with Black Cobra 1, because I feel like we need to break it down. Even though you can go back and listen to the previous podcast to get more detail, but like in Black Cobra 1, they started off where he just walks into like a YMCA and hip shoots bad guys with a shotgun.
He just roasts that motherfucker,
which is
in
like
the
best way to start an action movie. Yeah. We were all just like, yeah, let's go.
Yeah, this one started with a drug bust and then a quick little car chase or something.
It was a foot chase.
It was the slowest foot chase, but both of them were the slowest chases
I've ever seen. Because the car chase too was like they were going 10 miles an hour.
And the foot chase was across town.
Yeah.
Not across some blocks. It was across fucking town. They were going in and out of buildings. They're going up and down stairs. They're on the roof. They're in a basement. They're in the streets of Chicago. Yeah. They're in Kanye West's house. Like, it was everywhere.
They're taking a breather because Fred Williamson's out of breath.
Oh, God. Remember how his path for running, right? So you've got the bad guys running and he's jumping over the fence.
Path.
And then Fred Williamson is, like, using the gate door.
It's like, real exciting.
Yeah, it's real exciting.
Yeah, at that one point, do you guys remember when they're both out of breath? So they stop and get lunch.
Yeah, they had it was like 20 minutes. They had a really nice conversation.
Yeah, they were like, I'm going to get you. Can you get the tip? But yeah, what was it going to say? Do you guys remember when they're on the scaffold and the guy that is being chased by Fred clearly slows down and looks behind him to make sure he's
he
right.
Can catch up. Yeah, make sure he's in frame.
Holy shit.
He slows his pace down to like a jog, like an old woman jogging in the suburbs. It's like, we clearly can tell you as a stuntman have significantly cut your pace in half so that Fred Williamson can be on your heels.
Yeah.
And I get 3 morning jogs a day and 2 days of Pilates.
Yeah, it's that thing where the length of the scene equals exciting.
Yeah.
They were going by that flawed logic.
Yeah. It was a bit rough, that running scene.
You guys remember Casino Royale?
Yeah.
I know that movie is like 30, 40 years after this, but god damn it, that's a good opening action scene.
Opening action scene.
Yeah. Fuck. Yeah. Like they spend 2 minutes plot stuff. They're at the fucking dogfight or whatever. Yeah, and it's like, we need to get this guy. You need to get him alive.
Yeah.
And then the guy puts his... He's undercover and he puts his finger to his ear and he's like, get your finger away from your ear. Everyone can see.
Yeah.
And then they chase and it's the most
Stop
exciting
touching
fucking
your
thing.
Ear.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I mean, they're like jumping from like the tallest fucking skyscraping building equipment.
Did you know the guy in that scene, the guy doing all the parkour, that's the guy that invented the art of free running, parkour. He's like the godfather.
It's the French guy?
Yeah, he's the godfather of parkour.
Are you serious?
Dead serious.
Jeffrey Parkour?
Yes.
Although it's Jeffrey.
Jeffrey.
Yeah.
Because he's
Jean-Claude Van Parkour.
What's his name?
I don't know.
Oh, okay. I thought it was Jeffrey Parkour, but clearly we were lying.
That doesn't sound right. But that's why he's so good at it.
I'm pretty sure. I think his last name actually is Parkour because he's that much of an asshole where he's like, I'm going to name it after myself.
No, I don't think he's the G-spot guy. The doctor that found the female G-spot named it after himself. His last name started with a G.
Oh my God, really?
His dick was so small, but his ego was so huge.
Named it. That's weird. Yeah.
Yeah. The female orgasm, the good.
Yeah,
part.
that is super cringy right there.
That's very cringy. But then again, that's a long time ago when men were men and America was greater. And I think I'm mixing, you know, horrible ideals.
David Bell.
Yeah, let's get a picture of him, Josh. Because he doesn't look like a real burn victim. That is not him.
Looks like he's on the Jersey Shore.
No, it's a black guy. Do you not remember the movie?
Motherfucker.
Not Fred Williamson. He's black, clearly. But I'm talking the godfather of parkour.
The godfather of parkour.
Yes, that's what I'm calling him.
I'm calling him buildings.
That. Don't type that in. That's probably not a search.
That's gonna bring up a rapper or something. It was a white French guy.
No, can't be that guy.
Yes, it has to be. Even Godfather of Parkour brings up David Bell.
Oh shit. Well, I'm wrong. Well, I'm used to that. Look at my fucking life.
It's probably Sebastian Faucon you're thinking of.
Yes, that's who I'm thinking of.
Yeah. Oh, he's in the scene, huh?
Yeah, that's the guy.
Oh, right.
Yeah, he probably choreographed that whole fucking run scene.
Yeah.
Like the way he jumps through the...
The wall?
No, it's that open hole above the door frame for like
Chan
ventilation.
Shit.
Yeah, he just swoops right through it.
We're talking about a great movie
when we should be talking about an awesome shitty movie. Nonetheless, that's Casino Royale. Everybody fucking see that. But I see why you brought it up. That's an awesome set piece, awesome action piece. It is literally the same thing as Black Cobra 2. It's a foot chase in the beginning.
Right, but they make it interesting.
God, it's really good. So, but back to Black Cobra. Let's jump into the love interest stuff. Let's just jump around all over the film.
Yeah.
Fuck it. We have no form of structure.
The lady, she's the main interest, love interest. She's singing. She sings the song in its entirety.
Yeah.
Most of this movie is filler.
Uh-huh.
Like, they don't cut. They use almost, they, you know, they're like the American Indians of editing.
Yeah,
they use the entire cut. Yeah. They don't ever cut the fucking film. Like, it's
Thank you for this film.
Oh, my God. Like, much unlike the great Sum 41, this is all filler, no killer.
No killer.
Yeah, it's like...
You're right, though. It is all filler.
Fuck.
I said that at one point. I was like, why can't they just make a 45-minute movie? Why do you have to feel that the need to be like, it has to be in an hour and a half? It's 90 pages. That's just how long the MPAA or whoever figured out, we can get people to sit here for a long time.
Yeah.
But this is the right amount of time. Just make your movie 45 minutes. Who the fuck cares?
This movie is seriously
an hour long. Yeah.
But they stretch it to an hour and a half.
Dude, it's like, so long.
It wasn't originally this long, but they've realized that probably a month into editing. They're like, fuck, this movie is short.
Yeah.
We'll just do all of our shots, put it all in. Yeah.
Well, one of the things is that the whole movie is forcing Fred Williamson to fall in love with this damsel, right?
Mm-hmm.
The girlfriend of some guy that got murdered by the tip-top bad guy.
He's like three times her age.
Yeah. And her size.
Yeah.
He's a fucking hammer, and she is a tack. He's gonna bang the shit out of that. He's gonna bang it flat. No, but they're forcing this on us, and none of us could care in the room. All four of us were like, really? Come on. Get to the action. Yeah.
John
was falling asleep the first half, and we almost did a movie mulligan.
Yeah.
But I preached how we might end up with another bad movie. So it wasn't Left Behind, you know, where that was a definite
easy mulligan.
This, I was like, no, let's finish it. Let's watch Black Cobra 1 and 2. We got them. Now we'll always have them for, like, reference.
Yeah.
Thankfully, the second half of the movie fucking picked up. There was actual action. We were like, here's the movie.
Yeah, yeah.
It was jet-lagged.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think it definitely got a little bit better.
Yeah,
yeah. Still it, wasn't, think it, was it didn't necessarily shitty, become a good bad movie by any means, but it was at least like I could actually stay awake watching it.
Yeah,
yeah. Like they suit up for the final confrontation. Here, wait, let's hold off on that.
Let's dance around. Who cares?
Okay, all right, yeah. So they suit up Die Hard style, and we're
oh my God!
Yes, yes! And they're getting suit. They got God, like the harness. Yeah. And they've got tons of guns.
It's a fucking waste of time.
Yeah, it's like, what the fuck? They have guns. They have, like, strapped with, like, five different guns. And they end up just shooting, like, three people.
Yeah. No, they end
up... the movie's over.
Most of the time spent just climbing up an elevator shaft.
Yeah.
Right, but yeah, once they get to the top, like, Fred Williamson...
They kill like three guys.
Jumps
though.
Through a window and rolls over a table and shoots a dude, which is
the slowest Tootsie Roll I've ever
oh,
seen.
Yeah.
It was pretty funny though, right?
Yeah, it like, was funny. That's why it was hilarious. I mean, that's why we're enjoying
it's
talking
like
about it.
A 65-year-old man like diving through a window,
rolling with a shotgun, then has perfect aim.
Yeah, I think it was him.
Yeah.
I don't think he was a stunt double because it's slow mo.
Yeah.
And you see his face.
Yeah.
He actually did that shit, I'm pretty sure.
Well, it's probably sugar glass anyways.
Right, yeah.
But
exactly.
Still,
I was thinking
but nonetheless.
Of the other role that he did, too, though, where he was on the ground, the little ground roll. The
oh
ground
my
roll
God.
That was, like, the slowest, like, it was essentially just, like, moving at, like, a snail's pace.
Yeah. Dude.
And then he gets up and shoots the guy, like, the guy would have been there, like, oh, well, I could shoot him now, but...
Yeah, he could literally clean out his fucking gun.
Yeah.
Like sliding the chamber back and forth. Yeah, this is good to go.
Yeah,
shot him mid roll still.
Yeah.
But this is an Italian film, so there's lots of rolls and no one liners. Again.
Yeah.
Never any
one
liners.
Again.
I know.
Dude, we need to watch real blaxploitation with Fred Williamson.
Yeah.
I want to see. They've got the cigar, they've got the attitude.
Yeah,
they're missing the uncontrollable violence.
Yeah, all our Fred Williamson films that we've seen so far, none of them have been like true blaxploitation, like you're saying, because we had the two Black Cobras, which were both the Italian
ripoffs,
and then we had Original Gangsters, which was more like
retired.
Yeah,
that was like retired.
That didn't even feel like blaxploitation.
Well,
it just
they had
felt like
so
a
much
90s
budget.
Movie.
Well, neither
yeah.
one of these were blaxploitation.
Yeah, that's what
we're saying.
Oh,
it's
yeah,
like
yeah.
we need to watch.
We
some
need to watch real
absolutely.
Blaxploitation.
Fuck yeah,
something with Fred Williamson like. We need real blaxploitation because we're getting like the Dr. Thunder or like watered down versions of Dr. Pepper. You know what I mean? Like we're not even getting we're wanting.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
We're not even getting Diet Right.
Yeah. It's like we're not getting Coke, which is blaxploitation. We're getting watered down Coke, which is Original Gangsters, or we're getting Cola.
Yeah,
you know it says cola on the can.
Generic cola.
Yeah, and that's the Italian
cola
version.
Brand,
so like, we're not even getting the real product of
smart,
what we want.
Smart choice brand cola.
Smart choice, yeah, and it tastes like piss.
Yeah, that whole like the climax of him like them getting suited up. We should also mention that this is a buddy cop film too. This is buddy
what the fuck?
Buddy Cobra is what it should have been called because he's got this.
Oh yeah,
the white guy that clearly
that, like,
speaks English,
favorite,
but they dubbed him
yeah.
like you were saying, Josh.
My favorite with that dude though is that they like didn't like each other, and then just there was no like catalyzing factor,
inciting incident.
Yeah,
there's
no
make
inciting
them
incident
friends.
To make them friends. They just randomly started acting like friends.
Yeah.
And then they end it on fucking
the freeze frame.
The freeze frame of them being like best friends.
He's like, I'm gonna miss you, man. You know, doing all these missions. Yeah, it's been good, brother. But one thing, get your wife to fix your tie. Freeze frame. And it's like the guy started laughing, right? Usually you freeze frame.
Okay.
Here,
yeah.
I'll give you a sense of time, audience.
Here,
during
guys,
a freeze frame of a laugh, right?
Here, really quick.
You want
to the folks at home?
Yeah,
let me record video. Of
yeah,
you guys
we got
doing
this.
The,
we
the
got this.
Freeze frame here.
So, here we go.
Here
we go.
One
John.
Sec.
Yeah.
God damn.
Oh my God.
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 God. This is why we don't give Josh the camera. You got it, bud?
Yes.
Okay.
The freeze frame.
Okay. So. I'll do this, and then we'll laugh for a second, and then we'll stop.
Yeah.
We'll instinctually feel it.
Yeah.
Okay? So, one last thing. Fix that tie. And that's a fucking freeze frame. It pretty much does this. Hey, fix that tie. It's like immediate. Oh, were you doing that one too?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, whatever, Josh. Oh, whatever. Sit down, you cutie.
I'm supposed to show the folks what the freeze frame is.
I didn't know you were doing that one. I didn't know you was doing that. I thought you was only recording the good one. But yes, they fuck up the freeze frame gloriously, which was a nice cap to the movie.
Yeah,
at that point,
Fred's
we're all
face
rioting.
Was blurry. It's like, what the fuck?
The guy was like mid-laugh stroke too, like, like he hadn't even got into his laugh. Yeah. It was like the, it was like him, the saliva in his throat is cracking before a laugh.
Yeah,
freeze frame. So bad.
The main love interest gets shot.
Oh yeah, she dies.
Yeah, so then we're like, okay, so what is his motivation now?
So is it a buddy cop movie or is it a love interest movie? Oh, it's Lethal Weapon 2. Got it.
Yeah, but like after she dies,
don't you dare insult Lethal Weapon 2 like
that
again.
Movie. That's a great movie.
Fred Williamson is like, yeah, you got problems with your wife that we haven't established. Yeah, yeah. And then he's like, and then the wife gets kidnapped. The other guy's wife.
And the kid,
and
right?
And the kid, yeah.
And the kid, yeah. Yeah. It's like, man, this movie doesn't know what it wants to do.
Yeah,
like,
the motivation was for the wrong
character. Yeah, it was the wrong person.
It was literally the D character.
Yeah.
Like, we didn't barely knew anything, and then here's act three of the movie, and their best friend's about to go on a two-man death squad.
Ooh,
in this building.
I wonder if the love interest, like, midway through shooting was like, I'm not doing this anymore. I'm done.
Dude.
So they had to, like, completely change it. Well, we got to have some sort of...
Dude,
Jeopardy.
That is a good.
So they
theory,
were like, "We'll
man.
Switch it up to the other.
Seriously.
We'll switch it up to the other wife."
Like, we already have footage of her.
Yeah,
singing horribly.
Singing horribly.
We can't like reshoot the movie. That's exactly what happened. I bet you anything.
I want just that singing scene. I want that on our page. I don't care about the copyright claim. I just want that fucking
this
scene.
This whole movie is
so we can
on
watch
YouTube,
at any point.
So you can
put, really?
Yeah, you
oh,
can put the footage
yes.
nice.
On the podcast. So no one
nice,
will give a fuck.
Nice. So
we get a copyright claim from It's a Movie.
We get one every week at this point.
It's a Movie production.
I think I'm gonna have like a whole shelf dedicated to my copyright claims. Like people have Emmys and Oscars. Mine is like lawsuit, 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 lawsuit.
My theory is they had no script. I think they just
wanted
like,
to go to Manila.
Yeah, dude. Because
yeah, Fred did. The Italians were already in Manila, probably, right?
Yeah, something like that. But the structure
the
of this
Philippines
film
is not Italy, James.
I know, Bass.
The structure of this film is so fucked up that it feels like they were making it up as they went along.
Yeah, yeah. Especially Act Two, because that's when it just gets into lots of action. Like, just let's just shoot shit up.
Yeah.
For
yeah.
a lack of story, guy's wife gets taken. All right, start shooting shit up.
Yeah,
like they had some American come by. Hey, sweetheart, you need fucking explosions and gunshots and nobody wants to fucking listen to people talk. Otherwise, they'd stay at home.
Yeah. The wife's got to get taken. I don't know who you are. I got a certain set of skills. It's punching wolves. I'm good at punching wolves. That's pretty much my main set of skills. Hopefully, you are wolves that have kidnapped my wife, because I am not very good at punching humans.
Yeah,
punching wolves, however,
I
can
punch
great.
The shit out of some wolves.
So they suit up to get the girl back, right? And we're all like
the
getting
wife.
Pumped up.
We
and
are pumped.
There was already plenty of explanation that this was gonna be shit, but we still got excited. We were like, yeah, fucking going guns
like,
blazing.
I was like, this is that part of the movie where they suit up,
yeah,
and
yeah.
shit happens. I was so excited.
Me too. Yeah, and then
nothing
cut
happened.
To about 20-25 minutes of climbing an elevator shaft.
Oh, god damn it.
No joke.
I was so fucking disappointed, man.
It felt like the Metal Gear Solid 3 ladder boss.
Yes, the ladder boss, yeah. It genuinely did. Like, they used every... There's a scene where Fred has already entered, let's say, the building, what a skyscraper, whatever. He's John McClane at this point.
Yeah.
In blackface. And, John McClane in blackface.
I mean, not a lot of actors can pull it off. Bruce Willis did a phenomenal job.
Amazing. No, but he's, like, in the building, and then he's radioing the buddy cop. We'll just call him Butch Cassidy or whoever the fuck
he is. Just call him Buddy Cop.
Buddy Cop.
Yeah. We'll call him Buddy.
Buddy Cop, Buddy for short. So yeah, he's radioing Buddy, and Buddy's like, huh? Oh yeah, man, I'm just doing, you know, my last bit of things. And then it's literally a minute long shot of the guy walking across the elevator shaft with like his clamps and everything. And I was like, we don't need all of this.
Yeah, dude.
And then he got to the other side and then it cut. And it's like, we didn't need all of that.
Yeah, he
just literally say, like, okay, I hear you. Awesome. I'm going to finish up here. He goes to move a piece of climbing equipment.
Yep.
You cut mid
yeah.
movement.
Yeah.
Dude. In the back. Oh god, I was.
They climb this elevator shaft in real time. We see everything. We see him breathing in and out. He fucking pauses to have a sandwich. Like, we see all of it. It's like, oh my fucking god. Can you imagine Die Hard if they showed every little thing that John McClane was doing?
Yeah.
the dog is chewing on some of James's priceless belongings again.
I mean,
she get her teeth in that one?
No. Okay. It's really good. So yeah, PS4, PlayStation 4 control covers made out of silicone. Get one.
Dog chew on it.
Dog
Today's
chewable.
Today's episode is brought to you by PS4 silicone covers. Get one.
They're overpriced.
You can
$9 for this.
Really?
Yeah, it probably costs 10 cents to make this.
If that.
Impressive.
Fucking $9 for that?
They made
capitalism, right?
They probably made it in Manila.
Yeah, he dives through a window, rolls over a table, and shoots, which is great.
Did not make up for the movie.
But it was pretty great. And
yeah,
then,
maybe this... you said a supercut of this movie would be amazing.
Yo, dude, I want to re-edit this movie.
A supercut would be fucking amazing. Add your own voices in. We should all...
We should do that.
We should all add our voices in.
We should do that. I'd be down to do that.
I want
to
be the bitch singing. I want to be the bitch singing so bad.
Let's fix Black Cobra 2.
Dude.
Huh?
This sounds like our magnum opus.
It sounds like a good amount of fun. Yeah.
This sounds like the epitome of our life's work.
I'm
dead serious.
I hope not.
I'm dead serious. It'll be so successful, people will be like, well, you have to make movies now.
Yeah.
And then we can actually add one-liners like, 2-for-1 special.
Or you get the other one?
Dead motherfuckers float.
Ooh, yeah.
Classic. Or, your body's really good at taking bullets. You know, just literally anything. It doesn't have to make sense. Just make it funny and awesome. It's a one-liner, damn
Hot
it.
Shot.
Or, I got you, bad guys.
Bang. He says bang.
Yeah. Bang. But yeah.
I honestly would have taken that. I honestly would have taken that in either Black Cobra or Black Cobra 2.
Dude.
Too many cobras.
Speaking too many of... cobras. Dude, like, this movie
Remember
had no
that.
One-liners.
That'd be a good,
Oh, sorry. This movie had no one-liners.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what I was saying.
That's what we were touching on earlier.
Yeah, that's what you were saying. And it's like...
James is so disappointed in you, Josh.
No, I remember what he said. I'm just bringing up a point where...
He's not mad. He's just disappointed.
No, I'm on his thought. I'm disappointed, yeah, like, on what he's saying.
Movies,
I'm like, it was so sad.
Like, 80s, it was the time of the one-liners. And
it
this
really
movie
was.
Had none. And when do you see one-liners anymore? Never, except for Dread.
Yeah.
Dread was full of one-liners. I just watched it.
Beautiful one-liners, too.
And it's
They're
like,
badass.
Man, this is great. It's old school, man.
It makes you cheer. Like, it makes you, like, hell yeah! I am okay with the amount of violence in this movie because of that dialogue.
Yeah. And the one-liners are terrible.
Were you trying to watch a movie, Dove? You trying to watch Vanilla Sky
out,
or Fear of Loathing?
She's picking out some movies.
She just
at least she has good taste.
Yeah.
But, yeah, anyway, no one-liners.
Yeah, no Bullshit. One-liners. It's very disappointing. That's why I'm saying if we do a supercut, I'm going to throw one-liners all in this bitch.
Oh, fuck yeah. Fuck
I don't
yeah.
see why getting a haircut would help us in any way, shape, or form, but whatever.
One-liners?
No, supercuts.
Oh,
I don't know why we're going to do supercuts, but...
Come on down to supercuts. We're playing Black Cobra.
You know what I always do?
The volume's broke.
It's this really cool thing. So you go into Great Clips or Supercuts or whatever.
Uh-huh.
And about halfway through the haircut...
You leave.
Yeah. I've already pulled this one.
No, okay. That it just explains your haircuts.
Yeah, that's the joke that you stole from me. Yeah.
Thief.
I'm cool with that. Not mad.
I didn't steal your joke. I
He's
saw where
seething.
You were going. You pointed on a
seething
map and I was
anger.
Like, let's go to that destination. That's a great ride.
Yeah. Yep.
That was funny though. And then you just leave. halfway.
Yeah, you don't have to pay.
Your haircut looks like Oliver Tree, like, all the time.
I'm like half the Antwoord on my head. Okay, so what was the second film that we
watched? That was, yeah, I think that was pretty much enough for Black Cobra, too. Yeah, like, we honestly, I've been thinking about it, so we hit all the points I was trying to remember.
I think so, yeah.
Okay, so now the second movie, Python, starring Casper Van Dean and Robert Englund.
Yeah.
Although neither of them are the protagonists.
Yes, this was another disappointing movie. We should start that out.
I don't know. I really enjoyed Python.
I did too, but I'm one of those. I'm feeling like Python 2 was better.
Yeah.
I liked it better, yeah. It's shittier.
Shittier CGI.
The baseball scene at the end.
Yeah, dude. Yeah. It's
killing a snake with a baseball thrown grenade.
Yeah, come on.
Can you beat. Can it, Black Cobra 2 couldn't even done that. Yeah. They wouldn't have had the budget or the. You know,
they couldn't afford the giant snake.
The knowledge to even try that.
Yeah, they couldn't afford the giant snake. Have you seen that snake's rider? It's ridiculous.
Only purple Mike and Ikes. but yeah, so someone want to sum up the plot for Python?
Yeah, Jack. John, give us the rundown of Python.
All right. So we got Robert Englund and Casper Van Dean, and then a bunch of people I don't know nor care to know.
Yeah, even though they're on the cover.
Yeah.
Named.
No, the only people on the cover are Robert Englund and Casper Van Dean.
Really? Yeah, I thought there was a third one.
I don't recall. At least the one that I was editing in this previous podcast. Okay. Watch last week's episode, too.
Yeah, watch
seen.
Last week's episode.
Who's on the cover?
It's Casper Van Dean. It's the snake, but the names are Casper Van Dean and Robert Englund. And even though both of them only play like minor roles in the movie,
right?
But they were the names that people would actually be like. Yeah, they're the top build. And so,
Jenna McCarthy.
Oh yeah, Jenna McCarthy.
She got top bill in the credits, bro.
She did.
She got first credit.
She got very first credit.
Who's Jenna McCarthy?
The bitch that got decapitated by the snake tail.
Oh, yeah.
Spoilers!
Spoilers!
Also, how did that happen?
All right, we'll get to
science.
That.
Science.
Sorry, yeah.
Oh, science.
Science.
Yeah. But, yeah, so Robert Englund is a scientist. He looks kind of like, he's trying to do Dr. Hammond from Jurassic Park.
Yeah, he's even dressed like him.
He's dressed just like
just
him. To the
like
cane.
Him.
The
and
cane.
To those, and to the folks at home who don't immediately know who Robert Englund is, Freddy. It's Freddy Krueger. And
he's the pedophile in that movie. Maybe you've heard of it. Freddy Krueger.
Yeah.
Nightmare
on Elm Street. The Jason Michael Bay one.
Jason Michael Bay one.
The Jason Michael Bateman one. So anyways, he made these super giant snakes, and the Casper Van Dien's agency is the one that is transporting the snake, and it's the open establishing shot is the plane, which was the exact same opening shot for fucking Python 2.
Yeah.
Where there's a plane and it's a storm.
They even use the same footage where
the plane starts going down.
I forgot y'all
so the snake gets away, obviously, because of the crashed plane. And the plane starts to crash because the guy opens this like small wooden crate, and it's like, or like, it's a big wooden crate, but it's a wooden crate. It's not going to contain a 50-foot fucking Python. Like, I'm sorry.
I don't know. Wood is pretty sturdy.
Yeah, they're transporting it.
Yeah, they don't know what it is.
They don't know what it is.
And it's like, hey, should I open it up? I don't think I should open it up. I'm seeing movement. I'm giving you an order to open it up. I'm Randy Quaid.
Yeah, I'm giving you permission. Yeah, well, I don't think it was Randy Quaid.
He looks like Randy Quaid. Really close to Randy Quaid. God. Obviously, it wasn't Randy Quaid.
Imagine
he would have been the top billed actor.
Imagine being second rate Randy Quaid. That's this guy. Poor guy.
Like, yeah, they're like, why are they? Why? Why are you opening this?
Yeah, exactly. Like, why? Job. Yeah, why are you opening?
That's not how the military works.
No,
at all.
Yeah, I think they were private military, but it's still regardless.
Oh yeah, they could have been private military.
And
yeah,
it's
yeah.
one guy guarding this thing.
Yeah. Yeah, let's send one guy and then a pilot.
Yeah.
To guard this 50-foot python.
I want to say this movie had to have come out after Jurassic Park.
Oh, it did.
Because that movie opens with creature in a crate in Jurassic
True.
Park.
Oh, they wanted,
Jurassic
to, they
Park's
wanted
case.
To be Jurassic Park so
they,
bad.
They really
That's
did.
True, huh?
That's a giant metal container with this gorgeous set piece of one of the guards lifting the gate up, you know, like,
yeah.
even though it would have been tons, but
that
he just lifts it up.
Yeah,
forever
but, I mean,
in my mind.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, it's terrified me
it's
as
scary.
A child.
It scared the shit
hearing
out of
the
me.
Raptor.
Yeah.
And the guy's like, go.
And then yeah, and then you, like right before that, you have him explaining like what a raptor can do to you, to the kid.
Yeah.
It's just like, so you already have that thought in your brain.
Yeah.
And then you see that. Oh god, dude, that's a great scene.
Yeah. See, that's such a.
It's just a good movie.
Yeah,
it's
absolutely.
It's a masterpiece.
You guys watch Jurassic Python instead.
Jurassic Python. I'm pretty sure like. Everyone has seen Jurassic Park. If you haven't seen Jurassic Park, you've done yourself a disservice.
Yeah, I mean, it's the first of its kind.
Yeah.
Like, so many movies have mimicked it. Yeah. Point in case, Python, the movie we're talking about right now. Uncontrollable, you know, creature, larger than man, puts us down a pedestal on the, you know, the food chain.
Yeah.
Have you seen those teenagers? Python... Oh, sorry. Total digression. The teenagers, these, like, teenagers watched... Like Jurassic Park, they're on their phones the whole time.
Oh, it's one of
Are
those.
Are you kidding?
Is it one of those
and they were like, "This is the most boring movie I've ever seen."
It's the Fine Brothers, right? The blah 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 react. They found something.
Not sure. Yeah.
It's always in front of like a pastel screen, like pastel single color, like a blue or a pink pastel, something like that.
And then they
have headphones on. And they're looking at a laptop, and it's like old people react, teenagers react, blah 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 react.
Yeah, that's what I've seen.
Yeah. It's so.
It might be a veer off of that.
It's probably one of those options.
What he's saying is there's like lots of videos where it's like, kids react to VHS and like, have you seen them try to put in a VHS tape? They're like, where's the? How do you eject the disc or whatnot?
Really?
Like they have no idea what it is.
Holy
like it's
yeah, they've
just
made,
archaic.
They've made a multimedia empire off of just people reacting to things where it's like, look at these old people try and react to new things. Look at these young people react to old things.
How hacky is that?
Oh, dude, they're fucking, they're giant.
Have you
hacks.
Heard of Alien Art School?
Yeah.
Right, come on.
No, that's like,
we're hacky as fuck.
They literally,
they
appeal to the absolute lowest common denominator basic bitch.
Yeah.
Like that's,
and like the people, the clips that they're using, they're always like, it's so funny. Like, I've seen one of these, but only on TV.
Yeah.
And it's like, come on.
Yeah,
and you know
yeah everyone
so
everyone
annoying.
Acts like they're trying to be on that show where that used to be on VH1. That they would be
I
like,
I can't remember.
It would be like all second rate celebrities, and they'd all be watching like cringe videos and stuff.
Ah, oh, that sounds cringe Weird. Already.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's like, I get it. I can actually, I saw a reaction video that was like, oh, that was interesting. It was rappers reacting to that Asian rapper.
Kid. Oh, that's a really good react video.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're like blown
like,
the fuck away by
After
him.
You see one of these, though. Like
You've seen them all.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's like, what's the point? Anyway, so you were explaining the plot. Sorry.
Yeah. Plane goes down, snake escapes. There's an underground bunker, but that isn't shown until later. I think that's Robert Englund's place. It's somebody's bunker. There's an underground bunker. I'm trying to remember how the other people get there.
Okay, so we've got the snake.
Like the main character. Like, how did he even end up in this movie? Oh, he's a bike. He's a bicyclist, like an extreme bicyclist.
They don't get there. The snake.
The snake hunts them.
That makes no sense.
And it's in like a California town. Oh my god. The snake systematically hunts people down.
Coked up reality or
realtor.
Realtor.
Yeah.
Are you gonna close that deal?
Are you gonna close that deal?
He's the best.
He's
the best character in the movie, in my opinion.
Yeah. And then,
he's just going ape shit.
Oh, Will Wheaton's in this also.
Yeah.
Wesley Next Generation.
Yeah.
And
he's at his douchiest.
Yeah, he's at his douchiest.
Yeah.
His hair is like pink or like purplish.
Yeah, he's got a nipple piercing.
He's got piercings.
Yeah.
For those of you listening, I left. You don't care.
Despite looking like a in his punky douchiest phase, he's a realtor. Like,
oh yeah.
Think about that for a second. Like, would you buy a house from a dude that looked like that?
He's selling meth shacks.
No, Will Wheaton is not a realtor.
because the guy, he's trying. He works for the other realtor guy. Because the realtor's like, "Are you gonna close that deal? Are you gonna close that deal?" Like he's talking about.
I thought he was buying a house for him and his going
to be
about
selling
wife.
No, I'm pretty sure he was talking about selling houses because Will Wheaton was talking to the biker dude,
his friend.
About like, "Oh, she, I'm not gonna ask her to marry me until after I've until after I'm a big time realtor." Like blah blah blah. So I'm thinking he's like lower on the totem pole.
I thought he would just was saying in general, till I'm big time, like the realtor guy. Like, I have money enough to support her and me in a house and stuff.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
But the fact that he is a realtor makes all the sense now for why he looked the way he did. Because remember, I was like, he came on set. They didn't dye his hair. Like, yeah. This is during his drug phase, Will Wheaton's drug phase. Yeah. It has to be. And for you guys to sit here, two against one, and tell me he's a realtor, he was on drugs. Oh, he had to have been.
Yeah.
Nobody's buying a house from that guy, like you're saying, John.
Yeah.
I'm not trusting that guy.
What the fuck?
What, does he put on a suit? He still looks like SLC Punk. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah. He's like, he comes running up in, like, clown shoes. Sorry, I'm late. Puts on a red nose. So I'm the clown realtor. So we're going to take you to some quacky parts of the house. I'm not your average home salesman guy.
This is the bedroom. You can fucking hear. This is the kitchen.
You can fucking hear. The garage to hide your dead hookers, you fucked in here. I butchered that, but whatever.
We can fuck right now.
This is the neighbor's living room. You can fuck in here.
But yeah, well, that's a parody video we have to do.
Will Wheaton's snorting eight balls at a time. But yeah, so the big big time realtor guy that is not on coke.
Yeah, clear.
Not at all.
Never definitely even not, touched the stuff.
Yeah. Definitely not under the face of his watch.
Right. Yeah.
Oh, it's 12 o'clock. Had to do some more. Oh shit, it's 12:01. Gotta do more. Just fucking his coke clock.
That's accurate.
Coke clock.
But yeah, he's selling a house to someone that's not in the pornographic industry.
Jenna McCarthy. The cousin of Melissa McCarthy.
Yeah,
the larger woman that's a comedian.
Oh yeah,
smashing success.
She was in Spy, right?
Ghostbusters, the bad one. 2016. Ghostbusters 2016. Yeah.
But yeah, she's got a name for herself in the comedy world. I'm sure she's a funny person.
Jenna McCarthy?
Yeah.
Or Melissa McCarthy.
Melissa
McCarthy, I think, is funny. Jenna McCarthy made her. Is also a comedian of sorts too.
Is she?
She used to date Jim Carrey. Like, they were together for a really long time. Yeah.
Wow.
So, I mean, you can tell by her performance that she's more of a comical based actress. The way she was like doing her face, you know, because she's supposed to look like this slutty housewife that wants to buy a house, but it looks like she's gonna bang the guy in the bathtub or something.
That's the one joke. It just doesn't stop.
They beat that horse into the ground.
Yeah.
It's like, please stop, it died hours ago.
Yeah.
She's like, 14% down. He's like, I'll go 13. She's like, oh my God. Yeah. Like, it's like, we fucking get it. Yeah. This isn't funny. More about how Will Wheaton's selling houses, apparently. More of that. That's hilarious. Only in hindsight for me, though, because I just found out.
But yeah, he thinks the neighbor's kid is in the garage, so he goes in there. And
what was his name, John?
Billy.
John remembered.
Because earlier in the movie...
How do you remember that?
During the coke scene,
he's like, are you going to close that deal? Because he pulls up next to him in the car. Billy drives in front of them, or rides in front of him on his little bike. And this kid can't be older than like 7.
He kicks his Porsche.
And the guy's like, you Billy, you little asshole!
Yeah, okay, right. Yeah,
that guy is clearly on cocaine.
Yeah. But yeah, he's in the garage, and
it's funny.
And... So this giant snake is in the garage, a one car garage with a car in it.
Yeah.
And there's a giant snake in there.
And a bunch of boxes.
Like, yeah.
There's not a lot of room for the snake to move around.
The set designers were brilliant.
They were absolutely brilliant.
I mean, honestly, they probably had no budget, so they were pushed to the wall.
Oh, and then the snake, like when Jenna McCarthy comes downstairs, the snake has the dude in his mouth. And he's like flinging him around.
He's whipping him around.
Like whipping him around.
Like Jurassic
Park. And then when he throws him, the guy's fine. He's like, hasn't broken any bones or anything.
Yeah,
he's
not even bleeding.
Yeah.
You would think that the immense pressure of a giant python snake would literally just cave in your torso and everything.
You'd be horribly injured.
Just flattened.
Speaking of torso, let's get a little torso on drums.
Oh, yeah. Torso on drums. How could we forget torso on drums? Play us in, bud.
That's what I'm talking about. That sounds great.
I gotta remember to introduce that guy. Dude, Torso, you've gotta say something. Speak up. Okay.
He can't hear.
But anyways, you'd think that in a movie where like they actually establish the fact that pythons don't really eat their prey until after it's dead, they crush it first. Like, they literally say this in the movie.
Yeah.
There's dialogue explaining this.
Yeah.
Why doesn't it do that to the person?
Yeah.
It tail whips the lady's head off. It eats Coke guy. Like spits acid and eats Coke guy.
Yeah.
Like,
that's right. It does the whole acid thing.
Like, why even explain how pythons kill things if you're not going to ever actually have the python kill the thing
right.
in that way?
In that
and
way.
It's completely pointless dialogue.
It's pointless.
Wasn't it more like Spider-Man where they've like created an amalgamy of spiders into one, so it like it has all these different things. That's how
exactly.
the python was.
Yeah,
it
the
had
python
like
had all the different
super
traits.
Strength and size. It had spitting acid. Why not call it Super Snake or something like that? Like, why not come up with something other than python? Because python to me sounds like a movie where like a creature feature where it's like just one python crushing people.
Like anaconda.
Like anaconda. Every time I saw or thought about Python or Python 2 when we were gonna watch them, I would always think Anaconda.
Yeah, they just fucking nail it.
Yeah,
Anaconda's like,
great.
No matter all, in its immense schlock, I love Anaconda.
Yeah.
It's a fucking staple for me as far as like schlocky movies from the 90s. Like, I went to theaters to see it.
I still own it.
When
I saw it, that type of movie was right up my fucking alley.
Yeah, yeah. Nice. And the CGI at the time, I'd never seen anything like that. The way one of the guys jumps out of the waterfall, Snake grabs his face and then rolls him all the way up a tree. And it's like, this is all within one shot. And it's like, that is so cool! It's still cool to this day.
And
I'll still always remember
like the God's Eye, where like they're in the water and you can see the movement in the water
around them.
God. Cool.
Yeah.
I should watch that.
It's got Owen Wilson, Jennifer Lopez, Jean Voight,
Trump supporter. Sorry.
It makes sense. I mean, after you deal with big snakes, I mean, you'd probably want to just team with one, right? Bazinga. Satirical slam.
Yeah, we're a political comedy podcast now.
No, we're fucking hacks. This is a bedroom. And then it's got Ice Cube in it.
Yeah.
Ice Cube, isn't it? Dude,
it's
Ice
a good
Cube.
Movie, huh?
Yeah, dude, I love Ice Cube in movies.
Yeah, Ice
Cube. I like
great.
Him in my drinks.
He's hilarious.
I like him in my movies. I like him in my music.
My music.
But yeah, the
that's like I think it was one some I think he performed on some award show recently.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, I wonder, somebody posted something about it. I saw where it was like, I wonder how many kids saw Ice Cube performing and were like, why is the guy from like
are we there yet
on stage?
Yeah, they don't
that's
even know he's a rapper.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's sad.
Not for Ice Cube. He's a fucking badass.
He's multi-talented, and yeah, Ice Cube in his younger days, you would not fuck with him.
Oh God, no! I wouldn't fuck with him now.
Yeah, especially not now either. But I'm saying like before he had kids, I damn sure wouldn't have fucked with him.
Jesus Christ!
Yeah, he's a shit actor though.
Oh yeah, but I mean,
but
that's
I
what
him.
Happens when you get like.
So is LL Cool J, but I watched
popular,
Deep Blue Sea.
It's that was like the thing for the time was like you put rappers in
pig,
movies.
Yeah,
remember Double Team? Sorry, I couldn't even say that.
Freaking Romeo Must Die.
Yeah. Romeo Must Die. Rappers, not only. Never mind. I don't know what the fuck I was gonna say.
Although DMX, when directed right, was actually really like I really liked him in Belly.
Belly, I don't know that one.
Yeah. Belly's a fantastic film. It's Hype Williams. It's very visual.
Cool.
Really cool visuals.
Nice.
But, like it's Nas and DMX, and they're selling coke in Nebraska. Or
nice.
Is it Nebraska? I don't think it's actually in Nebraska. I just know there's a scene when Method Man is like, is it you? Is you the hottest in Nebraska?
Oh, okay. I got you.
The only good rapper actor is Mos Def.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, Mos Def's fantastic.
Yeah.
What's in 16 Blocks? You'll save me.
The way he talks in that movie.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's 16
just the way,
Blocks. He's like a baker. Yeah.
That's just the
baker.
Way Mos Def talks, though.
Yeah. No, I've heard him talk. He's doing like a voice in that movie.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, he's like talking to his mouth. It's like really weird because I've heard Mos Def talk, so I'm like, that's not how he clearly.
Have you seen Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy?
Yes.
He's really good in that.
Yeah.
Zaphod.
Exactly, yeah. He talks incredibly articulate in that movie. In 16 Blocks, he talks like somebody that just a poor education or whatnot kind of thing.
I don't think I've seen that.
I haven't seen 16 Blocks. I was basing it off of what I heard in the trailer.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's got Bruce Willis, right?
Yeah.
I can't remember that movie. Anyway.
Yeah. So back to Python.
How do you tail whip someone's head off?
Bruh, you just got to have the strength of a python developed by Robert Englund. and then just be the size of three sedans in a garage.
And yeah,
there you go, right there.
The force physics to do that.
Yeah,
like
it's like a clean cut too.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's like a makes no sense. It's like it would have to be ripped off.
Yeah.
Anyway,
that would have been cool though. But yeah, I feel like if she got tail whipped, period, like it would have just like caused her body to like horseshoe.
You yeah. know what I mean? Yeah. Like that, knocked like, her down. Yeah.
Internal bleeding. Bleeding out of the eyes and the nose and the mouth.
Python.
And
we can't expect anybody to put any rhyme or reason into their kills.
Yeah.
Should just bit her head off.
That yeah. made more for sense. Real. Yeah. Let's get into the meat of all right, the movie,
the real
really.
Meat and potatoes.
This is when Casper Van Dien starts talking with a fucking accent.
Oh, God. That there's was that, so too. Funny. But there's another oh part that we have to establish as well. The three bumbling cops. Or Billy Zabka and then the two bumbling cops.
Oh, Billy
cops.
Zabka's in this.
Billy Zabka,
because
Billy Zabka's is like the cool cop.
Yeah,
and he and protagonist were like best friends growing up, but they both dated the same girl, so they became they didn't like each other after that.
Apparently, it was the same girl that dated everybody in town.
Yeah,
we're right. talking women, children. Elected officials. Literally,
she,
apparently,
she
she's
dated
a whore.
Snakes.
Yeah, she has a snake in the opening scene.
No, that's a different. That was a different person.
Really?
The girl, yeah, the girl that Zabka and protagonist both dated at one point, where the protagonist was currently dating her, and Zabka dated her prior. I think
she's the Zab, girl. That's
I think protagonist. I think protagonist that dated her initially, and then protagonist went away for some
for
a
cares?
While.
This is...
And then Zabka dated her, and protagonist.
Like a beautiful
and then
mind
protagonist
now.
Came back and. They got back together, and so Zabka was mad, obviously, about
Have you
that.
Seen We Own the Night?
Two penises fight over a vagina. There we go.
It's the plot to We Own the Night.
It's the plot to We Own the Night.
Is that horror film? No, that's It Comes at Night.
Yeah, no, yeah. We Own the Night's Joaquin.
Yeah, I know, I was just fucking.
I just want to smack you for no real reason.
Play out my death, torso.
Just God, that's fucking awesome.
I'm dying, play me out, torso.
You know, the bounce back on the ball. Wow.
So we know who the violet one on set is. You're creating a hostile work environment in my bedroom.
I'm getting tired of your microaggressions.
God, I really want to talk about so many things other than Python.
Python, yeah.
Changing the subject.
Yeah. We all keep
continue.
Changing the subject.
We can keep. We can let it. We can let it.
Let's
be
power real. Through so we can talk about interesting things. All right.
Yeah. So the remainder of Python, we had the two bumbling cops and Zabka. The one is like Lewis. He's like a giant loser. He just wants to be. Cool,
oh yeah.
But he's a giant.
He gets off.
And he's
on
always
his...
yeah. And he gets off on power. He has a power thing. Where he's all like.
We're talking about the wormy nerdy one.
Yeah, the wormy
one.
Nerdy
yeah.
one.
From the Got Milk commercial.
Yeah, from the Got Milk commercial. Exactly.
He's also in Twister.
Really?
Rachel and I watched that two nights ago, and I was like, we were like, what the fuck? It's the guy.
Who is he in Twister?
I don't know. Just a same character, different outfit.
Yeah.
Oh, a fucking nerdy dude. Yeah.
Okay,
like,
yeah.
He's just a.
You can already tell that guy gets typecast as one type of character.
Like a wormy dude.
Yeah.
You know who else is in Twister?
Bill Paxton.
Him
Philip Seymour Hoffman.
Philip Seymour Hoffman,
yeah.
The one of the best actors to ever live.
Yeah.
Is
in our
that.
Time. Yeah.
And he says dumb lines, and it's funny.
He's great at it though.
Yeah.
Like he's so convincing as like the stoner rocker guy that chases tornadoes.
He's
like,
a brilliant actor.
Yeah.
Anyway,
two people in that movie that have passed.
Yeah,
that was a hard...
Philip Seymour Hoffman could come up to my house tomorrow if he was still alive, and say, "I'm you," and I'd be like,
clearly.
Yeah.
Let me see what my girl's doing.
Real quick.
The dog is running amok.
Amok.
She's running amok.
Downstairs.
Downstairs.
She got a business loan to run amok?
Yeah.
But yeah, the Zabka is in the house.
The
He's
Zabka
in the place to
in
be.
The house.
Z to the ABC and A. And he is, he really likes himself a lot.
Oh yeah. If there's one thing Billy Zabka likes, it's Billy Zabka.
Billy Zabka. And it's understandable, because, God, you know, he gives me an erection, and...
he makes me feel things that I didn't really know how to put into words.
You know, I would let him order me to sweep the leg any day. The leg.
The leg. He can sweep my leg.
Yeah, that's much better. Should have said that. He can sweep my leg. But yeah, what's up, Dove? How you doing?
She's like, oh, I was just busy eating Q-tips. You know.
That's disgusting.
I'll probably just hack those up later and let Daddy clean it. So yeah, we were talking about Billy Zabka, the bad guy from Karate Kid, if anybody didn't know. And also the bad guy in a lot of movies, usually.
Yeah. Well, I mean, once you play the bad guy in such an iconic film like Karate Kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're done.
They kind of want you to be the heel.
Yeah, you're always the bad guy.
Like it's so hard to watch a movie with James Spader where he's a good guy. I'm like, you're such an asshole. Like, watch any 80s movie ever. You're such an asshole
James
in it.
James Spader. Who's that? The name rings a bell.
Wasn't there that... Do you remember that law show called, like, Boston Legal with William Shatner?
I've never seen that.
He was the other pudgy guy.
I forget what it was called. I want to say it was, like, Blacklist or some shit. He had a show on CBS.
Yeah, Blacklist. Yeah. Oh, okay. He's also the voice.
Oh, yes, I know.
Yeah. A Stargate. There we go. That's the movie where he's a good guy. And I'm just like, it's hard to believe.
Yeah.
It's hard to believe that Kurt Russell's the bad guy in this movie and you're the good one. Yeah, okay, whatever.
Switch those.
Yeah, okay. But yeah. So, Billy Zabka.
Yeah, that never sat right. Kurt Russell, a bad guy.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's weird.
He's got that $1 million smile, dude.
Yeah. Kurt. Yeah. He's Kurt. Everybody loves him, Russell.
Yeah, absolutely.
He's Snake motherfucking Plissken.
Yeah.
It's very true.
But yeah, Casper Van Dien's performance was fucking hilarious.
I'm going to have to find the snake.
Oh, yeah, yeah. He didn't even know. He doesn't know how to do an accent. But he doesn't know how to maintain his shitty accent. Yeah.
His voice came through so many times, and we would just start laughing because we're like, well, there's Starship.
Oh, yeah. There were many times. The main thing that hit me, aside from when his voice would break, was when he would do the kind of like, I need to command my men so my eyes get real serious. And I'm just like, that's Rico.
Yeah, that's Rico.
That's Rico.
Yeah, totally.
That's Roughneck right there.
Yeah.
Well, John and I, we were making fun of it earlier. And it was like, Casper Van Dien wanted to do an accent. And the director was like, okay, perfect. What accent? And he's like, huh? And he just did all of them. He just did every accent ever. He was just like, I'm going to switch in between just voices I've heard in life.
Yeah. It's pretty funny.
So what accent you going to go with? Huh?
We do Russian in this scene.
God. It was like Cajun French. Ah, dude, it was horrible.
Yeah,
it was horrible. And probably my favorite part of the movie.
Yeah.
Any moment he started talking, I just stopped talking so I could hear what the fuck he was saying. It was so funny to me.
And when Casper Van Dien and Freddy they freeze because the python's in their sights. You guys remember?
Oh, yeah.
And Freddy's like,
dude,
don't
another
move
Jurassic Park.
Yeah,
I'm surprised
totally.
They didn't have the water scene.
Yeah. but yeah, he's like, don't move. You'll get eaten. Don't move. And so they're frozen, and then Casper Van Dien's like, I think I'll move, and I'll move and grab my gun and shoot the snake, and he gets eaten, and then we're like bummed out, like, the funniest part of this movie just died.
We knew he was gonna die though because we had already seen Python 2.
Yeah.
And Casper Van Dien is definitely I'm gonna show up for the second movie. Because I need the money. Actor. But he died in the first one, and so like.
What
I wasn't
that
surprised.
Other movie we saw him in?
Fuck, I don't know.
It was like an alien thing where he's like...
Is it... I think we might have it here on the rack.
I don't remember seeing him in anything else.
Yeah, no, there was a movie we saw him in where it was like, he works at like a satellite station and his daughter printed out like some like alien codes thing or something.
Oh, right.
Was that Extra? Nope, there it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, it was
Extra.
Was
no,
it
no,
Extra?
No, I see it.
The vector file. This one was great. This is a funny ass movie.
Yeah, we should rewatch this because I didn't get enough fulfillment on Casper Van Dien.
Well, if you guys remember, it was at the end of the night of watching three movies, and y'all were like,
"Oh, dude, I remember falling asleep." Yeah, that's
which
back
is understandable.
When we did three movies
in
a night.
The old threeskies.
Now, this movie
it'd
is
be
fucking...
okay if we did three movies starting at like noon.
Yeah,
but like
we could take a break. We're typically
doing these movies, what, like 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, and then doing the pod.
Yeah.
Dove, what you want up there, sweet? There's nothing up there, sweet.
The vector file is fucking hilarious. Ooh, Lionsgate.
So that shows quality. what was I saying? Casper Van Dean, blah, 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 blah,
blah, blah. It kind of sucked shit. Once he left.
Yeah, the movie sucked. But I knew he was going to die. And, God, the rest of the movie, man, I really just wanted the Casper Van Dien just and in a Will fucking Wheaton
bunker. Yeah.
The whole time.
Well, they both died way too early.
Casper, oh, that's right. Will Wheaton died.
Gets killed, yeah.
Little Wheaton.
Little Wheaton.
Yeah.
That's a dumb scene, too.
Yeah.
There's a giant snake.
Yeah, he's like, you woke me up for somewhere. A snake?
And he's like, you woke me up for a snake?
Oh, stop it.
Extreme wide shot. Snake.
Yeah, it's like she's taking a shower, and the snake attacks while she's standing in the shower, and it takes its time and doesn't... She gets a chance to throw every object in the shower at the snake.
Rubber duck.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. God. That was one of the worst scenes I've ever seen in any movie ever.
It's so bad.
Well, the logic and the rules set by the snake are the snake attacks immediately.
Right. That's what's
happened. It's like looking at her like, oh, let's play a game. Like, I'm a snake that likes to a little bit of foreplay.
I'm a sneaky little snake.
I'm a sneaky snake.
It's stupid.
It was very stupid. And then she uses the shower curtain rod to swing. She uses the shower curtain rod to swing, and that would never happen. She would have fallen on her back, and the snake would have probably laughed and then eaten her.
Yeah.
Because, like, that's how that works. That a shower curtain scene. Rod cannot hold the weight of a human being, much less a swinging human being.
Right.
I digress.
Stupid. Yeah.
So she gets out, and then that's when she's like, there's a snake down there! And Will Wheaton's like, you woke me up for a snake? Meanwhile, he's been wanting to get woken up just to have sex.
Well,
because remember, they don't have sex.
Well, they're supposed to wake up to meet up with people.
Right.
So he'd already been woken up to be like, hey, we got to leave. We got to go. It's the kind of thing. So,
and then he fell back asleep.
Yeah. So, like, he should have already been waking up in the first place.
Yeah.
So being like, you woke me up for a snake? It's like, yeah, you're supposed to be awake anyways right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very true.
Yeah.
You died.
The girlfriend should have died, and then him and Casper Van Dien should have killed the snake.
But then how are we going to get the snake to the bunker?
Yeah.
It'll show
the snake,
up.
The snake just
story will cause
it to show
up. Because
the snake chased her to the bunker when she was driving. She, like, takes their Jeep.
Oh, yeah.
And the snake follows her all the way to
the
bunker.
Oh, my God!
Yeah.
And then... And then,
I even said it. I was like, watch, the snake's going to be following her. And then there's the snake in the road.
Yeah.
It's like swimming. It's like just... what's the word you use for snakes moving?
Oh, serpentine?
It's just serpentining behind
serpentine
her.
Movements.
And we're just like, what? I just couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe that something so dumb I just said came out of my mouth was actually on film.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, okay. Oh, yeah, there it is.
Yeah.
Why did I expect it not to be? Driving. It should have been in a car, right?
Yeah.
I should have said that. Maybe then it would have happened.
And then there was a lot of, like, mountain biking in this movie, but they'd always have to put on a helmet and glasses.
And glasses?
Yeah.
Just because safety
a helmet
first.
And glasses.
You're being chased by a 50-foot snake, but safety first.
Yeah, you have time to put that on.
So
they rig the bunker to blow.
Thank
and
you.
Then
I was just about to say that.
They're like... So they lure the snake into the bunker, then they rig it with explosives.
Yeah.
And I distinctly, do you guys remember, when they have the explosives, there's a sign, and it says, if a giant snake is chasing you, use these.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so that's pretty helpful.
Very convenient.
Yeah.
Yeah, so they set those up to blow, and the guy does the Mission Impossible thing. Remember?
Yeah. Oh, that's, God. They did. They had him because he was in a biking outfit pretty much the whole time, except when he was like in scrubs when he worked at his at the acid plant. But like,
sorry, I've given up.
So the only time they take him out of the biking outfit is to do the Mission Impossible scene where he just dresses up like Tom Cruise and they lower him down just so he can do the little.
Yeah, I just that's the only reason is there.
I wanna add a little bit more to that scene. I want to add a little more to that scene. Not only is he dressed like Tom Cruise and he's got this harness for, you know, grappling and shit. He takes it off, right? And then runs down the entire corridor to then put on another harness.
Yeah, he puts...
Yeah.
He took the harness off
and, yeah,
to run around
and then put
on a different one so that he can then be pulled out of the said shaft.
Yeah.
Just leave the fucking harness on.
Yeah, it's
Have
so
you
stupid.
Ever done a time trial? You ride bicycles extreme for a living. You know what a time trial is. You know how to be efficient in moving. keep the harness on, you dumbass. But that's just a way to build tension so that we're all like, exactly. Oh, please don't get the main guy.
Yeah, and the bunker explodes. And it doesn't kill the snake.
Robert Englund sacrifices himself
to make sure because they have
just to have that in the movie. Yeah.
Well, he too was tired of the movie.
Yeah.
He's like, go on without me. He's like, why don't you guys leave?
The snake doesn't die, and then it chases them back to the acid factory.
Yeah.
And the whole reason he worked at the acid factory is so the cops could believe that he was the one doing all the murders.
Oh, yeah.
And so they could finish off the snake with acid.
Yeah, it's like, here's how you give your guy motivation to do something like that. The snake killed his son.
Yeah.
Like, and then he's like, okay, this snake's death is the only reason I'm alive right now.
Yeah.
Like, I want to fucking kill this fuck.
Right.
But you're expecting actual motivation in a movie about a 50-foot giant snake?
Well, I'm not expecting it. I'm just stating that this is how you make the movie better. It's not hard to add one line. Like he sacrifices himself for no reason. Just because. So, you guys should just all leave.
You don't
go to Chili's.
Yeah. Or Carrabba's.
Have an Anytizer.
Anytizer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You can have it any time.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
That's what I like about any Tizers.
Now, do they have happy hour specials?
Yeah, they do. Oh,
Did you know that you can get any Tizers at any Walmart?
No,
in the frozen section. Yes, you can. So you can literally have them any time.
Yeah.
Chili's is dedicated, bro.
Did you know that you can get anything from Walmart if you're fast enough?
True.
I want to say. God. Robert Englund's character as the scientist, let's call him Frankenstein in this movie, wouldn't he have known a weak point for the snake? Like, wouldn't there the whole last bit, like the last thing?
Again, you're
last
expecting
resort,
you're expecting this.
Let
to
me
be written
finish,
by
you wiener.
Okay.
So, but yes, I am expecting too much. I know. I am expecting way too much. But all you need is to be like, yeah, it doesn't like pollen. Or something. Like, just something stupid.
Yeah,
why not?
The,
it doesn't like recycled items. Just anything,
or
right?
Right.
And then you're like, well, we're going to set up a trap where we're going to throw recycled items on top of it. And it'll be like, no, don't throw, recycled stuff on me. This is the snake talking. And then the snake gets wise and he's like, I see what you guys doing because I'm a sneaky snake. That's recycled items up there. I'm not going in that shaft construction
area.
I'm not going there, so I'm going somewhere else. Then you have the climactic, how do we destroy it? And then that's when the explosives work.
Yeah.
Not the explosives work, and then the snake doesn't die, and then they're all like, let's use the acid.
Right.
Yeah. Why not use acid in the beginning, then?
Right.
If you had acid the whole time, just put the snake in acid.
No, that's a good point. Explosives are the last resort.
Yeah.
That's the thing that is guaranteed going to kill this snake.
Yeah.
And it doesn't somehow.
Yeah.
We don't even see how.
Well, this all comes down to what I've been saying, where a normal writing room goes like this, where it's like, all right, so what's the snake's weakness? Like, how do they kill it? How do they
hybrid cars?
How do we solve the conflict? And then they figure it out. This writing room was like, giant snakes!
John, you about knocked water all over the equipment, you goober. But yes, giant snakes. Yeah. Oh, it's giant snake time!
So yeah,
but that's very true. It was just giant snakes the whole movie. It was a made-for-TV movie, probably for sci-fi, and that's probably not a channel anymore. And
the Syfy channel is still around.
Syfy channel.
Yeah. S-Y-F-Y.
Yeah, you gotta get Dish. What's Dish? It's archaic. I'll take three.
What are you talking about?
I'm just doing a bit. Remember, I'm a hack. Torso, play me to my death.
Sorry.
Awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Torso.
Almost forgot to.
Yeah. Hey, Gloria, get rid of that asshole coughing in the back.
Hey.
Gloria used to be a... mercenary. Hired gun.
A soldier of fortune.
Yeah.
So yeah, fuck these movies. What's
your
best?
Yeah, fuck these movies.
Which one you think is best?
Best of the night. I'm going to go with Python. Python for me. Best of the night.
Python.
Yeah, what
say you?
I'm going to go with Python as well. Python.
Python gang.
I mean, Casper Van Dean's performance alone was better than everything
in Black Cobra. That's honestly what determined it. That's honestly what determined it, Casper Van Dean.
Well, Python for me, too.
Okay, rock and roll.
Yeah, steamrolled.
That was easy. Yeah.
No, that movie is pretty funny.
Yeah.
We were laughing through the whole thing, pretty much.
Yeah. Honestly, I like Python 2 more, like I said earlier in the podcast. Definitely. I think we all agree. That one just way more hackney. They did two lines of coke before they screamed snakes. But two giant snakes. Holy shit, you've done it. We're going to make enough money for more coke for the weekend.
But Black
Cobra, get your watch out.
Yeah, Black Cobra 1 is better than both Pythons.
Yes. I like Black Cobra, the first one. I mean, the shotgun scene alone in the opening of Black Cobra.
Yeah. And they're holding up a YMCA.
Yeah.
Great plan.
Great plan, yeah.
Where you expect to get $5.
Yeah. They're all volunteers, ass. Yeah.
How much time do we have?
We got a couple minutes to toss. I do want to say that we mentioned during our viewing of these two movies that we had an unintentional snake night.
Yeah.
Python and then Black Cobra. So that's pretty cool. We didn't plan that at all.
Yeah. The original movie I picked was The Cursed. And then Black Cobra 2 was so bad I had to I tried to save the night. Because we were all so bored.
But you did a great job, honestly. I know you're saying, don't panda to me. Spot on impersonation. We all know I'm known for my impersonations.
Yeah, James is great at impersonations.
But yeah,
I thought that was Josh for a second.
Get that nasty-ass dog rag away from me. So I watched Dread.
You watched Dread.
I watched it last night.
But we can't talk about it because John hasn't seen it.
That's okay. Now, another thing that I watched was El Camino.
Oh,
you guys seen it?
It's on Netflix.
Oh no, El Camino. Sorry. Yeah. I was thinking of Gran Torino. I already made that joke.
Remember, I was like, in the theater. This is the sequel. In the theater, I was like, the sequel to Gran Torino.
El Camino. I'm still old.
Now, Rachel and I, we need to watch Breaking Bad. I've seen Breaking Bad, so I could just watch the movie. I'd be fine. But she will have no context. Yeah.
She hasn't seen it?
She's never seen Breaking Bad, no.
What?
Yeah.
We're in for some binging.
Yeah.
Right after El Camino, I started watching Breaking Bad.
Really?
I'm like,
I need to watch Better Call Saul as well.
Oh, yeah, I've never seen.
I really enjoy Better Call Saul. I've only seen the first two seasons, I think. But it's really enjoyable. It's a completely different show where it's not nearly as gritty as Breaking Bad is.
Nice.
But it's still really
enjoyable. It's Bob Odenkirk. Yeah. He's amazing in Breaking Bad.
He's a good actor. Yeah. But no spoilers, but El Camino was fucking fantastic.
Oh, I expect.
That's all I need.
All the tension,
I expect nothing less from Vince Gilligan.
It has brilliant writing.
I expect nothing less from Vince Gilligan. I assume the cinematography was great as well.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we saw that in the trailer. Yeah, it looked amazing.
I closed my eyes about halfway through the trailer. I'm like, okay, sold.
I looked over and you were literally... fingers in your ears and your eyes closed and your just head is down. And
like a fucking psycho.
Like a kid, yeah. But I have to respect that. Like, watching that trailer, I'm so enticed. I'm like, God, this looks so good. How can you not watch it? And then I look over and I'm like, he is so goddamn committed.
James gets pissed at me for doing that.
Nah, dude, respect,
He's
man.
He's like, what is wrong with you?
Talking about Jim Jam, I'm assuming.
Yeah, Jim Jam.
For the folks at home, because it just seems weird.
So, in a nutshell, what did you think of Dread, now that John will be watching it?
God, it was fun. It was fucking fun.
It's great, huh?
It's a good movie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't remember. Were you skeptical when I handed it to you?
I was.
Yeah, because of Judge Dredd.
Jim Jam watched it with me.
Yeah.
We were laughing through the whole thing.
Dude, it's fucking
not at it.
Awesome.
Well,
yeah.
Actually, there was some laughing at it.
Laughing at it, but you laugh with it a lot.
I love it. It's a good movie.
Can you believe it just... bombed in theaters so bad that they weren't even gonna do a sequel then.
It bombed, huh?
It bombed so bad in theaters. Because like I said, everybody thought Sylvester Stallone one was shit. Well, why am I gonna watch this
one?
And that's what happened.
This one is way better.
I've also seen it in 3D.
What?
Ooh. Yeah.
Nice.
It's fucking awesome.
Nice.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty good.
John, you're gonna get to see it. This is gonna be good.
Oh, yeah.
This is gonna be good.
Dude,
So yeah, yes,
anyway, I want to talk about specifics, but it's okay.
We'll save it for the next podcast.
Yeah. Anyways,
we're
going to
have three podcasts where we talk about Dread now.
Yeah. People are dreading it already. But you can understand why I'm signed up on the petition to either make a sequel or a fucking TV show.
Yeah. In that style. I don't think... I do get it, yes.
But you don't believe it needs a sequel.
I don't think so.
Oh, man, dude. Carl Urban is a fucking
dude,
amazing.
Great.
Yeah.
He is
Carl
Dread.
Carl Urban is so great.
He is Dread.
He's such an underrated actor just in general.
He really is. He really is. I tell him that all the time. I'm like, Carl, you're so underrated, man. He's like, oh, thanks.
Yeah. You know, he's so humble, too. Like, he's just so humble.
You
didn't know? No. Yeah.
God damn it. I said no and you said yeah.
Carl Urban and him are like best friends.
Bruh. Yeah.
Oh, word.
Yeah.
Word.
Yeah. We know each other.
Yeah.
Well, to say hi to him for me.
They play bocce ball together on Wednesdays.
Bocce ball?
But yeah.
They play Australian sports football. The most confusing thing ever.
Say hi to him for me. No.
One of the things I want to talk about Dread that won't ruin it is the consistency at which he wears his helmet.
Yeah,
the whole
movie.
That's all you need. For those of you that have seen the comics of Judge Dredd and know anything about the lore, it's like, he never removes his helmet. We never see his face, and I could be wrong on this, but like, we don't see Carl Urban's face once. All we see is that scowl. That's all you fucking need. This lifeless mask and this judgmental scowl. That's all you fucking need.
Great.
And he is a badass motherfucker
like,
the whole movie.
It's like the faceless one. Like it's like when you have like the judges in a lot of film and TV shows and stuff where they'll be like shrouded in darkness and they're higher up from you.
Yeah.
It's like that. The mystery sense. And then there's also like the executioner would always wear the black hood.
Exactly.
Like so like it makes so much sense symbolically.
Dude, it's a fucking knockout. It's a fucking knockout. And its success was only made on DVD sales after it released.
Yeah, it's a cult following now,
It
right?
was word of mouth. Word of mouth. And I was unfortunately too late. I should have saw it in theaters to help support the film. Maybe my $8 would have made sure there was a sequel, but it's high hopes.
Yeah, it's incredibly violent.
Isn't it?
It's great.
It's so good.
It's so awesome.
John, I can't wait for you to watch it, bud.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll stop talking about it.
Yeah.
I've built it up enough. John, did you want to mention any movie that you've seen recently? I know we're probably pressed for time at this moment.
We're really pressed for time.
Okay,
really worth noting that I really want to be like, oh my God.
Oh, did you watch Salo?
Salo?
Yeah, 120 Days of Sodom.
Oh, I haven't seen that yet, no. Okay. I still need to. Yeah.
Watch it with your family.
I will. I'll make sure.
Grandma.
I'll get Gam Gams together.
Yeah, yeah.
Gam Gams will come and watch it with me.
I don't know why I'm saying this, but she actually won't be appalled in any way.
I know.
Yeah,
you don't know my you don't know my grand you don't know my gam gams. She likes some fucked up shit. She's the one that introduced me to Marquis de Sade.
Oh wow. Okay.
Yeah, she's about it. She right. Yeah. Anyway.
Well, on that note, guys, it has been a treat as always with my friends, my buddies, my blood, my brothers inside the studio here in Cinema Shat. It's been great talking to you guys. You've been great. We've been better. I heard that on one, and I was like, I'm going to repeat that.
Hey, do you want to watch Turner and Hooch?
No. But yeah, tune in for every week for Cinema Shat, where we talk about movies, entertainment, television, ourselves, the shit show that is our lives, and any and everything. So yeah,
yeah.
Till next time. Well, I'm glad you talked through all of that, Josh.
Yeah, please like and subscribe.